Thank you for the opportunity for me to present this paperwork. Thank you. My name is Fianti Femmilia Darmawan from Nopember in Institute of Technology in Indonesia. This paperwork focuses on the enhancements of the results, not the sensors, actually. In this opportunity, I would like to introduce you this emerging modality, Electrical Capacitance Volume Tomography. This ECVT consists of three main units, the sensing system, and then the data acquisition system, and the reconstruction display. Actually, this ECVT can construct a real-time and volumetric image of the brain. This ECVT is developed by Dr. Warsito, and at the first development, it used to detect cancer, brain cancer, and then some research say that this ECVT can be used to observe the brain activity. The principle is ECVT use capacitance principle. The sensors place around the helmet and then connected to the data acquisition system by a wire and then reconstructed on a display. When brain got a stimulation, the electrical potential in the brain changes. Now these electrical changes cause a changes of permittivity value of the object inside the sensor area, inside the helmet. Now, on the 2013, Mahendra do research that observed a visual activity of the brain, of human brain with ECVT. He said that changes of permittive value caused by electric field disturbance from brain signal. So the visual activity can be detected by the ECVT. And then on 2014, Dr. Warsito do research for a human brain motion. The results shows that brain activity was changed by motoric task. And then the newest research on 2015, Mrs. Handayani do a research on the music effects. She said that ECVT can be used to observe auditory activity. The problem is, in this research, she used music as a stimulus, where we know that music affect complex brain activations, not only the auditory area, not only the auditory cortex, but also the other parts of the brain. So in this research, I want to prove that ECVT is really affect the auditory, detect the changes in the auditory cortex area. This is the measurements we did. We do it in the audiometry room with ECVT, with the helmet placed on the subject's head, and then the stimulation played into the right ear from the loudspeakers. Because we cannot put any headset into the sensor because it will cause a problem with the sensors. And then the stimulus, we use a single tone, a random single tone with a frequency of 500 and 1000 and then 4000 hertz with an interval 12 seconds, and then the stimulus as long as 6 seconds. These measurements run in 3 sessions. Each session run in a different frequencies. This is the reconstruction of ECVT, how ECVT reconstruct the brain image. The main formula is the capacitance matrix and then sensitivity matrix, and then the permittivity matrix. This permittivity matrix is what we gonna find, is what we construct this ECVT image. To get the permittivity matrix, we do a iterative linear break projection, and then we construct from the capacitance matrix, the capacitance we use the average subtractions, where the it can shows capacitance value inside the brain. This is the image processing process. From the ECVT datasets, we gather the capacitance value of the brain, and then we get a slice. In this research, I got an axial slice and then the sagittal slice. Now, ECVT image contains a volumetric image, which is X, Y, and Z plane. So the axial slice, there are 32 image, the ECVT image contract 32 on X plane, and then 32 on Y, and then 32 on Z voxels. So this is after we got a slice from each ECVT image, we got a modified centroid. This modified centroid is after the ECVT image being sliced, get a slice of ECVT image, we do the clustering. And then we find the centroid of each cluster of image, and then we do a spatial referencing, and then color segmentation. And then from the color segmentation, we get the auditory activations, and we apply it on a brain template. We get auditory activity image. This is the brain template we use for my big brain project. Since ECVT reconstruct 32 voxel, we got a from the left to right slice from bottom to top of the brain. Now this slice is what we gonna observe. This is the approximate auditory cortex area, and then this is we determine a volume of interest. We approximating the auditory cortex area in this pixel. We adjust it to ECVT image in 32 pixels. Now, what interesting is the ECVT results show a clear distinction between of condition when the humans doesn't hear stimulations between the on condition when humans hear a stimulation, a sound. It shows a low permittivity value, and then these conditions when the subjects hears the stimulus, it shows a larger permittivity value. Now this is the ECVT image. ECVT reconstruct the image like this in a color scale from blue to red. I forgot to add the color bar. From the blue color shows permittive value of 0, and then the highest permittive value shown by red. Now in this image, we can see that the permittivity value is so low. But in this off conditions, when humans doesn't hear stimulations, it doesn't the permittivity distribution is so low. In it's all blue. And then there's shows a larger permittivity distribution. This is the sagittal view, and then this is the axial view. Now after we do the image processing and apply it in a brain template from Big Brain Project, we got a results like this. Now we get a auditory activity area shown in the red color. in the brain. This is the sagittal view, and then this is the axial view. Now, these positions located in the volume of interest we determine in the first time. So, I'm sorry. These results, we do a correlation to the subject one as a reference, because this in this research, the subject one shows stable results in the permittivity distribution. Now in this correlations, we get a very low accuracy and consistency actually between each subject to the subject one as a reference. But in this result, in image processing results, we get a conclusions that brain activation area for and after image processing match the volume of interest placed between this axis, this pixel. And then from this research, we can know that ECVT can be considered as a promising technique for classification of activated brain area for neuroscience applications. But however, we do know that these tools, this ECVT, is need much more improvement either in the sensoring systems or the data acquisition systems, and then the reconstruction display. The problem is this ECVT, the temporal resolution of ECVT is still low, is only the retrieval time of the acquisition around 3 seconds. It's still long for neuroscience applications, too long. And then the reconstruction display, yeah, we need much more improvement too, because the spatial resolutions is lacked, of course. We still cannot define the area, the brain exactly, because of the shape of the sensors is too rigid, is in a helmet shape. We get a lot problem actually, but in this first stage of development, I think we can be considered ECVT for the neuroscience applications. I think that's all. Thank you.